We're joined by Mr. Prasad of Dr. Reddy's. Dr. Reddy's is the India partner of the Russian firm which is producing Sputnik V. That's going to be rolled out here in India, sir. My first question to you, the rollout of Sputnik, when is this going to happen and in what numbers?
So we've just started having our conversations with our partner. We should soon be getting product from hopefully in May itself, but latest it will be in June. And it will be, I hope it will be large enough to start meaningful effort. But I don't have the exact numbers today, but we will ramp up quite fast. And in June, we should be in full swing, hundreds of thousands of people. The total commitment, as you know, it's 125 million people to be vaccinated using imported product. But of course, they have their own supply challenges, commitments, and all that. In parallel, we are going to start working with the Indian contract manufacturers to get the indigenously manufactured product rolled out.
Sir, what you're basically saying is that the first installment of raw materials needs to come in?
Not raw materials. The first lot of vaccines will be imports. Fully developed, imported. Fully made, ready to administer.
Okay.
From Russia. After that, we will activate Indian people, and they're already activated. They're scaling up, doing all the protocols necessary to start manufacturing, establish the equivalence, and then bring in the indigenously made product for people in India.
And so, sir, just as a clarification, how many doses of the initial import will be ready by May or June?
That's still being negotiated, but several hundred thousand is my view.
And would you be able to roll it out as soon as it comes? I mean, is the chain of distribution settled?
Roll it out. They're ready to be administered.
Okay, that's great to know. Sir, we now have a liberalized policy as far as vaccination in India is concerned. As I understand it, there would be different prices for different groups. So at the center, there's one price. The states, there's another price. And perhaps... you know, if in the future, if citizens want to buy the vaccine, there'll be a third price as well. So how are you pricing Sputnik V in India?
So firstly, I think the imported product will be only for the private market.
Right.
It's allowed for the private market completely.
Right.
Our partner wants to price it globally at the similar level. The global price is $10. And I'm, hoping that'll be the ceiling for the price in India. So initially we'll start with that. Once we start manufacturing, we'll have to export some of it and also give it to the public markets in India. And that pricing model we will have to figure out,
Mr. Prasad,
coming weeks.
Right.
Ceiling being $10, it should be a little less than that, and we'll have to figure out what that is. And that product will be available both for the public and private markets.
Sir, the public and private markets, I take that point. But so is the initial batch, is that going to be going entirely to, the private sectors, private citizens at $10?
We haven't said $10, but the global price has been $10. So we are indicating.
Right. And so approximately that, and the subsequent prices will hopefully be less than $10, right? Provided to the center and state government. Is that right?
Yes, and the private markets also.
And so the private market, basically in a finite period of time, you'll have one price for India after the initial lot, or will there be more than one price?
After the imported vaccine is exhausted, then by the time the Indian thing comes, we will have...
And so the private market...
Not one price for all of India. I think the private market will be a premium market.
And so the private market will be a premium market, right?
I mean, there'll be some level of cross-subsidization, I guess. So we haven't figured that out. But I'm hoping that the private market will be a... We don't have to subsidize people who can afford a jab, right?
Yeah.
So there are rightfully the government... has to, look at equity and also social responsibility. And that is something we also would like to do. So we'll have a combination of that and this.
Sir, as you know, I mean, all too well, every day people are focusing on new variants, new mutations. And the question for Sputnik V is the same. How confident are you that this will give us the protection that we seek against the mutants that are now being reported?
So I have very early stage data, and it's not good for me to say anything on that. But all vaccines seem to have some efficacy on the mutants. And the important thing is, even if the mutant is there and if you're vaccinated, the symptoms are relatively mild. So I think being vaccinated is important. I think, like the seasonal flu, we will see booster shots tailored for mutants every season. And eventually, I think the pattern will get established. But at this point, it's a bit too early to speculate on that.
Sir, there's a very common question. You know, people who are getting a vaccine now are getting either two jabs of Covishield or Covaxin. Now, you've come into the market a bit later on, and there is talk of a booster dose perhaps several months later on. So could people at that stage potentially switch to Sputnik or to another vaccine?
They could switch. They could switch, and there's something called multilogous protection, and is being better than a single shot. So potentially they can switch. But the second shot, they should take the same one that they took on the first one, because data is not there.
Right.
How these multiple things work. The data that is presented to the regulator is of the second booster shot being the same as the first.
Right.
So I think unnecessarily, without evidence, speculating is not good on this.
Right.
But once you finish your two shots, I think there are a lot of studies going on of combination trials of different vaccines.
So one, a few more questions. Firstly, the temperature at which the vaccine can be stored. And secondly, there's also very interesting powdered version of Sputnik V. How could you tell us about these, sir?
So the current temperature stored is recommended is minus 18 degrees, minus 18 to minus 24, something like that. We have a measles vaccine supply chain historically in India, which is at minus 20. So we are going to leverage that. And we have also augmented some of that with cold storage points at various parts of the country, across the country. So the cold storage and the cold chain is well established now. And we have validated it. We have done multiple dry runs. We feel comfortable with that. The lyophilized product is going to be stable at 2 to 8, but lyophilization is a very complex process, and it will require a lot more filling capacity held up, because the lyophilization cycles take multiple days, whereas liquid can be done faster.
Mm-hmm.
So I think there is an opportunity to make the 2 to 8 degrees lyophilized product, which is the powder you're speaking about, but it has a cost element of capacity on it.
All right. Well, lots of factors over there, but it's great that Sputnik is finally going to be rolled out in the month of late May, early June. And let's see, hopefully a lot of people will get a jab, because we actually do need a vaccination to step up a lot. Thanks, sir, very much for being with us.